And this will kind of lead us into what I'd like to share for a third practice here, which forms a pretty strong foundation of the chapter of the book that speaks about somatic psychology and the power of really attuning to where the body is still stuck in defensive responding, and how we can also work with the body to really help access resource states. So this journey through the social engagement system from the eyes down to the belly will actually start this next journey through what I call the satisfaction cycle. And I didn't come up with that term. It comes from body-mind centering, the work of Bonnie Bainbridge Cohen and Susan Aposhin, who developed body-mind psychotherapy. That's a psychotherapy rooted in body-mind centering. I go into a whole lot of detail about this in the book, in the Complex PTSD Treatment Manual. But what we apply in the satisfaction cycle is the way that we can access resource states through the body to help prepare us for trauma reprocessing. And the first part of the satisfaction cycle is that ability to yield into gravity. It's the ability to feel your relationship to the support that exists underneath you, right? If you're sitting in a chair, it's that ability to really feel your back body held by the chair, your seat resting into the seat of the chair, right? And you can join me with this experientially that when we can feel our relationship to gravity, and the satisfaction cycle is actually built upon the study of how children learn to move through the world. So the first experience of the body in the world, ideally in a context of safety, is one where we can yield into being held and supported, right? Even in utero, we're yielding into the support of the womb if it's a safe womb. We're yielding into the arms of the caregiver if it's a safe caregiver. Now, with complex trauma, those environments, those earliest holding environments, are often not safe. And what happens is that there is this bracing against or this defensive responding that gets carried in the body. And this can begin even in utero, right? It can even be transmitted as legacy trauma if it wasn't safe for your parents and your grandparents and your great-grandparents and so on and so forth. There's all of this research, and you can look at, as David Wolin's book, it didn't start with you, right? You can look at Rachel Yehuda's research, and I speak about all of this in the book on, a section on transgenerational trauma, about how children born of mothers, and this is primarily where the research lies, who had highly stressful pregnancies or experienced trauma during their pregnancy, have modifications in how they're responding to cortisol. They're more prone to colic, their lower birth rate. And so there's more tone, there's more vigilance in the body right out the gate, right? So that capacity to yield is compromised. So we start with, sometimes we end with yield, and I'll speak about both, but we want to ultimately reclaim our ability to yield, because if we can't yield into gravity, it interferes with our ability to rest, digest, sleep, right? Like our basics. And ultimately, it interferes with our ability to intimately connect with another person, right? To fully receive the support and the connection requires that we actually let that all the way through, right? We receive it, we yield into that connection. You can imagine again the infant in a safe environment really yielding into the connection of contact, or that kangaroo carry, right? Like just that connection. Once we have a well-formed yield, and again, you can do this experientially, we can press into the ground and find the resource of push. And what I'll name here is that often we need to reclaim a push before we can go back and reclaim a yield, right? So this satisfaction cycle doesn't always get reclaimed sequentially. So a healthy push lets us actually push down. Right now, like I'm sitting in the chair, I'm pushing into my legs and feet and sits bones to find my spine and to move upright into the world. if you watch children that are laying on their bellies, right? Like little children who are lifting up into the world, they're pressing their arms into the ground to lift their chest and be like, whoa, there's a world out there, right? Like we find that connection to the support in order to come out into the world. And we start doing that through that push. We can push through the legs, we can push through the arms, right? And so we can find grounding, right? Grounding is really waking up that sensory experience from the hips, the pelvis, all the way down to the feet, so that we can feel all the way through that push come through. So I have my own standing. I exist, as Alexander Lowen puts it, that grounding is really claiming that you are a person, that you have that experience in the body of I exist. I'm claiming my existence, right? So we push in order to feel our own presence. If you push through the arms, and you can do this with me, if you're pushing through the arms, it's a way of affirming, this is where I begin and end, right? I'm not merged and collapsed. I'm pushing to be able to say I'm differentiated. I've got a self, right? And while we want to be able to have that intimacy of just yielding into support, we also want to know that we have the range within our nervous system and our physiology to say, and I can be a separate person. I can go into connection and I can have a self, right? And that feeling of having a self, whether it's, again, I need to have a firm boundary in some situations, sometimes I need to have a negotiated boundary, right? Where I can say, well, these are my needs. And I hear that you have your needs, and we can really explore the both and, right? But that push helps us navigate the world. And with a well-formed push, we can explore what it feels like to reach. Because I have a push that helps me know where I begin and end, and I can reach into the connection with another without totally giving up on myself, without totally giving it away, without losing myself. For those of you that have taken my therapeutic yoga classes, and you can find them on YouTube, there's a huge emphasis on that experience of finding the push in the body, feeling your relationship to the ground, so that when we open the heart, we're not just giving it all away. We'll injure ourselves, right? And in the world, if we don't have a well-formed push into the pelvis, into the legs, into the feet, into your own standing, and we reach into another, we lose ourselves. Right? We collapse into the other. And so we're looking for that push as the foundation so that we have yield into gravity, we have push into gravity, our ability to reach into the world for connection. Super vulnerable, right? We reach for connection. And then once we receive it, and it can be a connection with a person, with nature, with a tree, right? Like whatever it is, with your tea, right? Once we have that connection, and I'm going to model it, right? Really receive it. Let yourself have it so that the satisfaction cycle goes from yield, push, reach, grasp it. Let yourself have it. Bring it to yourself. Take it in. And it brings us right back to yield, because in order to receive it, whether it's the loving gaze of another person, whether it's taking someone's hand and their hand taking yours and really feeling that loving contact, right? Whether it's the loving words that have come into your ear and letting that go all the way into your heart, whether it's the nourishment of a good meal that goes all the way through and tasted and received and digested, right? That we want to come through that entirety of the cycle so that we can come back into yield. And, you know, and that we access that whole somatic cycle of what does it feel like to rest into support, to push into the earth, to assert a separateness, to reach for connection, and to receive it.